The Wolfmueller 3-Minute Parables here at the Higher Things Retreat in Concordia University, Austin, Texas, to see if I can explain a parable in 3 minutes or less. Today is the, right now we're going to do the parable of the seed that grows in the middle of the night. This is a parable that's only in the Gospel of Mark.
Let me just block out Andrew's face.
Okay, ready? Go. Jesus says, "To what shall we liken the kingdom of God? Or with what parable shall we picture it?" I started the wrong parable. Okay. "And the kingdom of God is like a man who should scatter the seed on the ground," verse 26, "and should sleep by night and rise by day, and the seed should sprout and grow, and he himself does not know how. For the earth yields crops by itself, first the blade, then the head, and then the full grain in the head. But when the grain ripens, immediately he puts in the sickle because the harvest has come." Now, this is a really unique parable of the Gospel of Mark that Jesus tells there. Mark alone has this. None of the other ones do. But this fits in with all the other seed parables, the parable of the sower, the parable of the seed and the wheat and the tares and all this sort of stuff. This is the parable of the sower who sleeps at night. And here's the point. The sower, the farmer, goes and he plants the seed. And then what does he do? He goes to sleep. He doesn't do anything. He just sits there and he waits. And he's waiting and waiting, and the seed just grows up out of the ground, and he doesn't even know how it grows. He doesn't even know how it happens. And Jesus says that the kingdom of God is just like this. The word of God is planted in our hearts, and it grows, and we don't know how it happens. If someone comes along and they tell you that this is how to make the church grow, this is how to work in the church, this is what the church looks like, when you know that they're wrong, because Jesus in this parable says, no, the farmer simply sleeps, and that's it. It grows in itself. And this parable is reminding us that the power in the church, the power in the life of the Christian, the power that we have in Christ is not in our own works, not in our own efforts, not in our doing. The power is in the Word itself, that the Word grows, the Word accomplishes it, the Word does its work. And what do? We rest. That is, we trust in the Word. We rejoice in the Word and the kindness that it gives to us. So that's the parable of the sower who sows and then goes to sleep. 3-minute parables.
Thanks for watching us talk at you. If you want to see us talk at you some more, subscribe to see notifications when we talk at you the next time. Donate to support Higher Things at higherthings.org/giving. Help us to help you. And if you like this video, check out our website at higherthings.org and check out more content from Higher Things.